Hello everyone, now we can discuss our next test from laboratory test category, that is falling head permeability test. Some people also call this test as a variable head permeability test. Okay, this test is used for fine grain soil. If you want to determine the coefficient of permeability of fine grain soil, then you can use this falling head permeability test. First, I want to sketch the experimental setup used in this test. So see here, we have one soil sample something like this. This is our soil sample. Of course, there is a one inlet and there is one outlet. So if I talk about inlet, so at the inlet we have inserted one stained pipe. This is made of glass tube, one stained pipe we have, and at the outlet also we have one small pipe from where discharge can be collected. So from here we are collecting the discharge. Okay, so like that we are collecting the discharge. Now we have given the water from here and we are collecting the water somewhere here in this water jar like that. So here we have the free water surface. Okay, this will be my soil sample. So I can write, this is my soil sample. Of course it is fine grain sample for which coefficient of permeability I want to determine. The coefficient of permeability I can determine for this fine grain soil sample. Let me confirm you, the length of this fine grain soil sample is L. Of course the length of flow path will be L only. Now what happens when we give some amount of water supply in this test? There is a fine grain soil here. So when I give, suppose I have one bag of fine grain soil and I give one glass of water, so it takes a lot of time to come out. Why? Because the permeability is very less. So what happens, it takes a lot of time to drop or pass through this soil sample. Therefore no need of applying continuous supply. There is no need of continuous supply. What is happening? You give some amount of water, after some time this head will drop. So what I suggest, suppose at any time t the head is suppose h. The head is suppose h. So I tell you at this time, suppose the head is h, the difference between two water level is h at any time. Let me tell you this time is t. Okay, at the time of t we have the head h. Let me tell you, this is the time t1, this is the time t1, and at this time we people can have the head h1 and this head drops to somewhere here also after some time, maybe after the time t2, the head we can have, suppose h2. Okay, so at any time t1, the head difference we have h1. At any time t2, we have the head difference h2. And at any time t, at any time, random time t, we have the head, suppose h. Clear? Now, if I tell you, suppose 5 liter water I am giving in this stand pipe. Let me tell you, the cross-sectional area of this tube, the cross-sectional area of this tube is A. I can write, the cross-sectional area is small a. This is the cross-sectional area of this tube, small a. And the cross-sectional area of the soil sample is suppose capital A. So, small a is the cross-sectional area of the stained pipe and capital A is the cross-sectional area of the soil sample. What I suggest, suppose if I give 5 liter amount of water, clear? So, suppose from here to here, water is dropped. Initially, the water level was here. After some time, water will drop here. Means, suppose I have given 5 liter of water, the same amount of water will pass through the stand pipe and the same amount of 5 liter water will pass through the soil sample. Means, the amount of water which is dropped from initial condition to final condition, the same amount of water is flowing through the soil sample. Am I right? So, suppose through the stand pipe, X amount of water is flowing, then through the soil sample also, X amount of water will be flowing. So, here you see, if I say, the head is dropped by dh. Suppose this is your dh. This portion is your dh. And this head is dropped in the time dt. In the time dt, the head dropped is dh. Clear? So, what is the volume of water dropped? How much amount of water is passing through the soil? It's very simple. Water dropped of thickness dh. So, thickness of water is dh. And what is the cross-section area of the tube? That is A. Means, the total amount of water is A into dh. Am I right? This is the volume of water dropped in the tube. Now, where it is going? It is going in the soil. So, same amount of water is passing through the soil also. A into dh. Area into this much amount of water is dropped, dh. Clear? Can I convert this volume of water into discharge? Of course, this dh, this much amount of thickness of water is dropped in dt time. So, volume divided by dt, this divided by dt. So, this is the value of your discharge Q. So, through the tube, through the stand pipe, this is the stand pipe. Through this stand pipe, A dh by dt, amount of water is passing and the same amount of water is passing through the soil also. Getting my point? So, here I want to write discharge passing through stand pipe is equal to discharge passing through soil sample. Clear? Now, what is the amount of discharge passing? So, A into dh divided by dt. Here, I want to use, see, A into dh is the is the volume of water, and in the time dt it is passing, so it is the total amount of discharge. Here I want to use the negative sign, not with A, actually with D, this term. With this term I want to use negative sign. Why? Because you should know one quantity. See, there are two quantities. One is dH and another is dt. These both quantities are into opposite directions. I mean to say dH, it is the fall. The water drop is water head is dropping. So one quantity is decreasing, the head is decreasing. So head is continuously decreasing, and dt, time is increasing. Time is not stopped, time is increasing. Initially it was t1, then t2, then t3 and t4, time is increasing. So dh is decreasing, time is increasing. So that's why one quantity, if the one quantity is increasing, one quantity is decreasing, we people should use negative sign there. So here I am using negative sign. So this is the total amount of discharge. It will be equal to discharge passing through the soil sample. We know Darcy's law. What is Darcy's law for discharge value? Q is equal to KIA. So I am writing the as per Darcy's law, the amount of discharge passing through the soil is KI into A. That's it. Small a is the cross-sectional area of the stained pipe. Capital A is the cross-sectional area of the soil sample. You should note down. Now, A into minus dH by dt equal to K into. What is I? I is the hydraulic gradient at any time t. So you see, at any time t, what is the head difference? At any time t, the head difference is h. So I can write head loss h divided by, h is the head loss, okay, head loss divided by length of flow path, that is L. You see here in the figure, what is the head difference? The head difference from this water level to this water level, the head is h at any time t, and the length of flow path is L. This much amount of distance water has covered in this soil sample. So h by L, and A is the cross-sectional area. I want to determine actually K value. See here, I can write minus dH, and this h I can write here equal to K divided by, okay, K into A divided by this small a into L, and we are getting dt here into dt. Is it clear? Now both the side we can integrate. So here I am integrating, here also I am integrating. What should be the sign of means limits of integration? So you people should understand, at the time here actually integration I should apply, this is the this four values are constant, okay, so integration we are applying here in dt, okay. So you people should notice dt at the time t1 to at the time t2. Here head limits we should take. At the time t1 we have the head difference h1, and at the time t2 we have the head difference h2. So I can write, at the time t1 we have the head difference h1, and at the time t2 we have the head difference h2. Clear? Now here you can see there is a negative sign. If I want to remove this negative sign, I can change the limit. I can make upper limit as a lower limit and lower limit as a upper limit if I want to remove this negative sign. So see, I'm removing the negative sign and I can write dh by small h, and this I can write limit as h2 to h1 will be equal to negative sign I have removed, okay, and the limits I have changed. I have reversed the limits. So k into a divided by a into l integration of dt from t1 to t2. Now dh by h, of course it is log h, so log will be natural log ln h, log base e, okay, ln h and h1 to, sorry, h2 to h1, h2 to h1, k a by a l, and this dt will be your t, and this is t1 to t2 limits. Here I can write the limits log h1 minus log h2, so log m minus log n will be equal to log m by n. So here I can write log h1 by h2 will be equal to k a by a l and the time t2 minus t1. Here I can write the coefficient, here I can write this natural log can be converted into the log base 10 by multiplying 2.303. So 2.303 I am multiplying and writing this natural log as a log base 10, h1 by h2 will be equal to k a by a l. This t2 minus t1 is the time difference that can be denoted by capital T, time lapsed, time difference, okay. Now we want to find the coefficient of permeability k. So the final expression of k is with us 2.303 al by at log base 10 h1 by h2. 2.303 al by at log base 10 h1 by h2. This is the expression to define the coefficient of permeability. Getting my point? This is the coefficient of permeability. Here the meaning of each and every term you people can understand. I can write a is the cross sectional area of the tube. Cross section area of the tube. Tube means stand pipe. I can write cross sectional area of the stand pipe. Now capital A is the cross sectional area of the soil sample. Okay, h1, h2 are the heads. So if you want, I can write h1 comma h2 are the heads at any time t1 and t2 respectively. Okay, capital T is the time lapsed. Capital T is the time lapsed, which is equal to T2 minus T1. Other things you people know, everything I have written here. Now what actually we want to do in this test, if you are preparing for GATE exam, you should know this expression. Derivation is not important for you guys if you are preparing for GATE only, but if you are preparing for ESC, engineering services, then everything from starting to end, everything you should know. One more thing I want to discuss here. Suppose one very important thing I want to tell you. This test is performed in number of stages. This is not a result of a single observation. There can be number of observations at different time intervals. For example, suppose I start this test at T1 equal to 3 o'clock, 3 p.m. I start the test, and at this time, suppose the head I have measured H1, some value we have of H1. So at the time T1, at the time T1, we have the head H1 that we have measured. Then at the time T2, suppose the interval we are taking of 15 minutes. For example, okay, so suppose the next reading I have to take after 15 minutes, and the next reading is H2. How will you take the readings? Simple, head difference you have to measure. Suppose initially at 3 o'clock you start the test. At 3 o'clock you start the test, you observe the head difference is H1. After 15 minutes, means at the time T2, you measure the head, that is H2. This is the observation you have to take. Then next reading again we have to take after 15 minutes, suppose that is T3. After 15 minutes means at 3 o'clock 30 minutes, the next reading we have measured, suppose H3. Then after 15 minutes T4, next reading H4, after 15 minutes, so like that, at every change in 15 minutes, at every time interval, we are taking the number of readings, number of observations. Okay, suppose I start this test from 3 o'clock, 3:15 I take reading H2, and at T3 equal to 3:30, I have to take one more reading, that is H3. Okay, so what happens? I take this reading at 3 o'clock successfully. Now the next reading I have to take at 3:15, just after 15 minutes. But because of some reason, I was not available to measure the reading, or I forgot, or I slept, suppose. So I could not taken this reading. Now the time comes of third reading. Suppose third reading I have taken successfully. Means I have missed this second reading. Second reading is not with me. I have missed. So what I can do now? If I want to predict this value of H2, okay, what should be the head difference at the time of 3 hours 15 minutes that we can predict, that we can estimate? How will you estimate? You see here what I am going to do. First I will apply the same equation. This is my standard equation, okay? This you have to remember, it is very important equation we have. So this is the equation of coefficient of permeability, and the coefficient of permeability is the property of material. It will not change. It is the property of material. It will not change with the time. So what I am going to do, first I can apply this equation between T1 and T2 time. So you see, I can write first observation. For first observation, what I can do? K equal to 2.303 AL by AT log base 10 H1 by H2. This I can write. Everything I know H1 also, but H2 I don't know, because I slept at that time, 3 o'clock 15 minutes I slept. So H2 is not with me, other values are with me. Now comes to the second observation.
और सेकंड इक्वेशन मटेरियल इज सेम, वी आर परफॉर्मिंग द टेस्ट ऑन द सेम सॉइल आफ्टर 15 मिनट्स ऑल्सो. सो नाउ आई कैन अप्लाई दिस इक्वेशन ऑन इन बिटवीन H2 एंड H3, आई मीन टू से T2 एंड T3. इन दिस टाइम इंटरवल आई कैन अप्लाई द सेम इक्वेशन. So the coefficient of permeability will be same because the material is same. I am not changing the material, okay? In case the material property, it will not change. So 2.303 AL by AT standpipe. It's a constant standpipe cross sectional area. Length of flow path is also same. Cross sectional area of the soil sample is also not changing. It is same. Let's talk about capital T. Capital T is the time difference. It is the time interval. So in between these two, time interval is 15 minutes, and in between these two, T2 and T3, again the time interval is same, 15 minutes only. So this capital T is also same. So log base 10 here I can write as I have mentioned here H1 by H2. Now in this stage I can write H2 by H3. This is suppose my equation number 1 and this is suppose my equation number 2. In this equation everything I know, I don't know the value of H2. In this equation I do not know the value of H2. You take equation 1 divided by equation number 2, 1 divided by equation 1 divided by equation 2. So I mean when you divide, what will you get? We people, either you can divide or better, what I can do, we can put equation 1 equal to equation 2. Both will be same, no problem. So if you put equation 1 equal to equation 2, because it is also coefficient of permeability, it is also coefficient of permeability of the same material. So we can put equation 1 equal to equation 2. So when I put 2.303 to this 2.303 is cancelled, AL by AT to this AL by AT is cancelled. Only we have log base 10 H1 by H2 equal to log base 10 H2 by H3. So I can write, you people will be having log base 10 H1 by H2 to equal to log base 10 H2 by H3. Log to log is cancelled. We are having the final stage of results H1 by H2 because log to log is cancelled. Equal to H2 by H3. So H1 by H2 is equal to H2 by H3 we have. So I can write H2 square equal to H1 into H3. So the final value of H2 we have H1 into H3. So this is the result of H2 which I have missed here. So because of some reasons, if you are not able to measure any reading in between the given time intervals, then using this concept you can estimate that value. Clear? So in this fashion H2 can be determined. So this is a different approach. Your test is completed here only. It is just for information. Some additional things I have discussed today. So in this lecture we have discussed about the falling head permeability test, and this test is suitable for fine grain soil. If I compare our previous lecture, previous test, that is constant head permeability test. So in the constant head permeability test there was a continuous supply of water. Why? Because there we were using coarse grain soil. In the case of coarse grain soil, if you give the water, immediately it will drain out. So you cannot perform the test. So there should be continuous supply, so that you can perform the test. That's why people have given the name constant head permeability test, used for coarse grain soil. But if you have fine grain soil, in the fine grain soil, if you give some amount of water, it takes lot of time. So test can be easily performed, number of readings can be easily taken. So that's why here there is no continuous supply of water, just one time investment, give the water, now wait for the results. There is no continuous supply of water throughout the test, okay? So that's why the head is dropping continuously. Initial head was here, now the water is dropping. That's why people have given the name falling head or variable head. Head is varying. So falling head or variable head permeability test used for fine grain soil. Clear? I hope you are clear with this. In the next video, we can discuss about our next method to determine the coefficient of permeability, that is horizontal permeability test, or I mean to say horizontal capillary permeability test, that we can discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.